Okay, now we'll see how TestNG works and what the different ways of using it, what are the limitations and what are the common practices that we have to follow while using TestNG. We'll see that now. Okay, for that I'm going to create a new class. Okay, that too I'll create in sample package exam. What is the common practice? You should be giving test in class name. Okay, that's a good practice. Now, anything you want to test, it should be something like that. Okay, so public void test one and then brackets. This is a method definition. So inside that, whatever the code that you want, you can write. How do I know that that has been executed? If it is printed, this system.out.println is printing, then you can understand that, okay, this method has been triggered. Okay. So how do you run this test one method? By keeping @test before this method. Okay. So import test org.testng.annotations. Okay, right click, run as testng test. So it's executed, it's printed, I am test one method, and then it worked. Okay, you see public string test one. Something it is returning. You have your test method is returning string. Okay, so what happens if there? I'm just telling you what is possible and what is not possible. Okay, now it is saying, see, no test run, no tests found, nothing was written or nothing was ran. That means your test case, whatever the method that you are considering it as a test case, should always return void. Okay, it should not have any return type. Okay, so it should be always void. That is the first rule that you should have. Okay, and the second rule is, let's say you don't give public. That means it's a default now. Okay, it's executed. That's fine to give. That is fine even if you don't give. Even if it is private, it has been executed. So there is nothing to worry. You can give anything like public, private, or protected also. But make sure that you always give public. Okay, that is the second one. Now, string. Now you are passing a parameter. That is string AS. See, it's failed. And failed, but the message is cannot inject @test_annotation with method test one with a string. Okay, so there is, you cannot directly pass a parameter to a test method. What you can do is there is a certain way to pass this parameter. Right now, think that this is not possible. Okay, if you want to make your test case, you should be using public void and the test name without any parameters. Okay, then your test case will be executed. If you have multiple test cases like this, so duplicates are not possible, it's basic. Three, four. So totally we have five methods, and if I run this, you can see. So right click, run as TestNG test. You can see total 5 has been executed and then 5 got passed. So what you have executed is you have executed this class. When you execute this class, you can run all the test methods inside that class. Okay, so you can see it more clearly. Go to the run as and go to run configurations. In the run configurations, you can see in the left side, there is this button TestNG. Okay, if nothing has been created, you can just double click on it. It will ask you to, it's a new configuration. Select the project, which project that you are executing, SST2. And then in the SST2 project, you can run whatever the class that you want to do, browse. And then there is two classes which contains the @test of TestNG. So you can choose any one, okay? And then apply, run. So this is how it executed. The same way, when I use run as TestNG test, what it will happen? It will check what project it is. It will check what class it is. And then it will run all the test methods inside that. Okay. And if you go to the run configurations, you can choose the method too. Like you have 5 methods you have. You can choose which method that you want to execute, apply, and then run. So only that one method will be executed. Okay, you can do the same thing by selecting this method like this. Okay, double click and select it, right click, run as TestNG test. It will run only this particular test method. See, one method test case, the two test 3 has been executed. This is how you run your test cases. Okay, I am just making sure you know all the possible ways of running it. Okay, so you can run a class, you can run a test, and if you have this package, right, if you have the package and you have multiple classes, there are 2 classes we have, okay, and then there are 2 classes and 10 test cases we have, okay. So how do I run these 2 classes? If I run from run as TestNG test, it runs only this particular class. Okay. What is this? Okay. So only this particular class will be executed. So for that, you need to go to the run configurations, and here you can select package and browse, and then test scripts are sample. There are 2 packages which contains the test cases. I am selecting sample and then apply, run, so that now 10 test cases will be executed, which is in both text example 1 and example 2. Okay. Any questions here?
Yeah, this is like one class having 5 cases. These methods are cases, right? Like 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 1, 2, 5. Those 2 classes having 10 cases, we are running based on the preference.
Yes, exactly. Okay. So when I say these are test cases, when you keep this @test, if you don't have @test, only 4 test cases will be executed.
If you don't have @test for test 6, and if you want to run, we need to keep it @test or any other alternative if you want to run only this 6.
Okay, so how do you want this to be executed is the question.
Yeah.
For example, this independently you want to run. Okay, so then you have to keep @test, and then if you keep @test, then only this will be executed. Okay, or this is not a test case, this is a reusable method, then you can call it from other test like this. So when you run test 7, test 6 will be triggered. So if you want to only run this, then you have to keep arbitrary test and select this and then run. So identifying which belongs to arbitrary test or which belongs to test case or not, we have to take that call. Okay.